everybody. So, continuing to deburr the stiffeners for the aileron skins. And then we'll do a little bit of prep work on the skins, and then I disappear. And then I come back and keep working. It's a short video. As you can see, I'm just deburring holes there. So yeah, part of this video process is very weird. Trying to keep up with all the files. This is not what I do. And you know, I keep apologizing, and I am sorry. I try to keep these things in time. Not in time, but in chronological order, but it's tough. So here I'm just showing my mechanic all about the stiffeners and what step I'm in. I've actually gotten to help our new club mechanic build some brackets for a couple of cowl fasteners. Ours were cracked and need to be replaced, so I helped him make them. It's pretty cool. I got to use my real life home building skills to help the club. I mean, normally I wouldn't be allowed to do that. I basically, you know, help make him. He puts it all in and he signs it off. So there, I've removed all the vinyl from the aileron skins. They're pretty flat. And here's where I left the hangar for 6 hours. So I sped all that up by like 1,000 times. And you'll actually, it's funny because if you look in the bottom right hand corner, the vinyl comes alive. And here I am back deburring the skins. So like I was saying, these skins, there's nothing really special about them. And because of that, there's some valuable lessons you can learn later, which we will be going over in the future. But these skins are basically, there's two bottom skins and two top skins. And their top and bottom are the same. Like, there's no special holes, there's no special bends. There's a cutout that you can tell what the bottom skin is, that's easy. But, I mean, they're not completely symmetrical. There are certain holes on certain sides, and you need to pay attention to that. Or you'll do like me, which, like I said, we'll talk about that later. So anyway, I'm doing the deburring of the skins because it is time to deburr, scuff, prime, dimple, then rivet. So that's what we'll be doing soon. Apparently I just left, because I'm useless. Well, there I am, kind of. Anyway, I will see you in the next video.